first dancer we're going to see perform in the hip-hop final is 18-year-old locker and popper Harry Barnes from Merseyside.
Dancing has helped me to express myself. For example, say I'm in a bad mood, I can quite easily put a song on that I like and just kind of lose myself in that and just dance, and just it puts me in a good mood. I got interested in dance when I was 12, when I joined Animal Dance Company, and ever since I've just kind of grew up here. It's like my second home. My mum had suggested me come in and just giving it a go. I thought, oh yeah, I might go for a couple of months and then probably fade away and carry on playing footy, something like that. But then after one class, I just wanted to come back every day. It was amazing. I like to do popping and locking. They're my two favoured styles, I'd say. But I also love to do hip-hop and house and even breaking.
Harry now teaches classes at Animal, where he hopes to inspire the next generation of street dancers.
A credit to teach, and I can't wait to see the things they do with their dancing, hopefully, in years to come. Main thing in dancing, always, 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 always keep practicing. To be chosen as one of the five to represent the hip-hop culture, I'm really proud of myself. And my first performance is popping. It's quite serious, but it still has that funk in it as well. I'd like everyone to take in how intricate it is and like the little beat hits and stuff like that. Second piece is locking, so it's a different style. I'm dancing to a track that's called What Do I Have to Do to Prove My Love to You, and that's the character of it, really. So I'm asking the audience, what do I have to do to prove my love to you?
My love. Harry did great. He stepped it up, especially his second piece. It was really good. There was little parts of the character that he wasn't really committing to before, and he completely did this time, so it was great.
The first one I wanted to be quite serious and them to really watch and take in every little movement, which I think they did. And then the second one, I wanted to create like a party atmosphere, make people smile. That went well as well, so I'm happy with it.
Harry, right from the start, he had such dynamic clarity and a real range. And, you know, he really puts himself in the moment, and I felt he got us off to a fantastic start.
His performances were really good, very clear. There was like a good narrative, and he executed very well.
So who did enough to win this hip-hop final and claim their place in the grand final at Sadler's Wells? DJ Renegade was the man in the know.
After a lot of deliberation and some crying and stuff, the winner of the 2015 BBC Young Dancer hip-hop category is Harry Barnes.
There's a sense of danger with Harry, you know, you feel he's so in the moment and so alive. You know, he's a natural performer, and he's got a lot of charisma on stage and, you know, technique to go with it.
He knew how to engage his technique into dance, into music. He has just been really constant in his solos and in the battles.
You're looking for consistency over the whole night and strong performances and a good level of battling, and he delivered.
I made up that my hard work's paid off. Obviously, I'm surprised that I didn't come here and expect to win. I came here for an amazing experience, and I've got that as well. And I'm just made up it's not over yet.
Next stop for Harry, Sadler's Wells and the grand final. You'll be able to see that in full on BBC Two on May the 9th. But there's still a chance for the other hip-hop finalists. Two wildcards will be chosen from across all four categories, and we'll find out who they are at the end of the ballet final in 2 weeks' time.